rough week, Kevin. Everything that's gone down has been tough for you emotionally and physically, but the tough has had to be losing the match to Goldberg and losing Scott Hall's career in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, I mean, if you watch the tape back, it's clear that there's interference. If Scott Hall's contract was really, if they wanted Scott Hall back, they would put the match in a cage and say, you know, no interference, let's have it for all the right reasons. But this company had no intention of bringing Scott Hall back. Management, Brad Siegel, TBS, TNT, and anybody else that has a say-so, including Goldberg, didn't want Scott Hall back. So Scott Hall wasn't coming back whether I won or lost.
Well, those are some strong comments, but let's assume they're correct, and I'm not doubting you, Kevin, but if they are correct, you have to understand what's going through the mindset of Brad Siegel and the muckety-mucks at TBS. Scott Hall is a bit of a loose cannon. He's got a reputation, and well-deserved.
Yeah, so is Val Kilmer, but he's a great actor. The thing is that, you know, the only time this place has been popped since Ted Turner's owned it is when Hall and Nash came from New York and the Outsiders came on the scene here. Hogan was here, Flair was here, Sting was here, Luger was here. Everybody that's currently here right now that's a star was here before Scott Hall and Kevin Nash came. So the ingredient that popped the territory was the Outsiders. And you've got half that equation sitting at home with a chance maybe to make the magic happen again, and they're not doing it. That's what you've got is people that don't know the wrestling business running the wrestling business.
Well, with all due respect, Scott Hall's injury situation has been rather chronic, to coin a phrase, over the last 6 to 8 months, maybe over the last 4 to 5 years, and currently he's not 100% from what we hear.
A chronic injury, I mean, yeah, is he injured occasionally? Yeah, is he work injured more than most of these guys? Yeah. Is he injured right now? Absolutely not. He's at 100%. He could be on TV on Monday.
He's 100%.
That
flies in the face of what we heard, that it's the shoulder, the knee, the back, and everything else that's injured on Scott Hall.
Who's that coming from? People that are trying to cover their own tails that don't want Scott Hall back. He's not injured, and that's that.
What do you attribute that to? Why don't they want him back? We know what the internet says. We know what the locker room rumors are. Kevin Nash, tell me why Brad Siegel doesn't want Scott Hall here.
One of the things I always hear is he's a locker room cancer, you know. But, you know, I guess you're a cancer in this business if you go up to somebody and tell them the truth to their face. If they have a horrible match and you go, how's my match? And the guy says, it was brutal. You should have had it in an iron lung. Then that guy's a cancer. You know, Scott's what he is. What he is, he's a real human being. If you ask him a question, he tells you exactly how he feels. If it hurts your feelings, then don't ask him a question.
Scott Hall's gone from World Championship Wrestling. How much longer will Kevin Nash stay with World Championship Wrestling?
Well, I've got 17 months left in my contract, and I honor my contract, so I've got 17 months. I'll be here for 17 months. After that, who knows?
Free agency to the highest bidder?
Not to the highest bidder. It won't be, at this point in my career, it won't be for money anymore. I've got enough money to live happily ever after. So now it's going to be for fun. And I have a real good time with Scott Hall. So they're not going to let him play in the sandbox here, and somebody else lets him play in the sandbox. I guess I'll have to go to that sandbox and play with my buddy again.
Bill Goldberg, there's a history between you and Bill Goldberg that dates back to his first world championship reign back at Starrcade 1998. Now, apparently, this situation has gotten way beyond what happens inside the ring or in front of the cameras with you and Goldberg.
The situation with Goldberg is that the company let him have too much power too soon. And it's like giving a five-year-old kid a Beretta automatic with no safety. He doesn't know how to use the gun. So it's a bad situation. My job, the way I look at it, is that I have to disarm this guy. So I have to do whatever I have to do, either politically in the ring, whatever I have to do, I have to make sure this guy's kept in check. He was a good guy at one time. He's not anymore.
Hasn't paid his dues.
9 years from now, he probably won't have paid his dues. I mean, you pay your dues when you walk in the door, you know. He hasn't had to pay him from day one, so who's gonna hold him accountable? He doesn't like the business. You know, he thinks he's going to be an actor or something, and it just...
Well, we know sometimes that what we necessarily see on television isn't what we get, but you really don't care for Bill Goldberg, the man, do you?
No, he's changed. I mean, he's changed dramatically. He walked in the door, humble bumble, helped me out, and guys like Scott Hall, who took him under the wing, are guys now that he's trying to do whatever he can politically to keep out of the company. Anybody that's a threat to him and exposing him or whatever, he's got to be kept at arm's length. And like I said, Scott says it how it is, and that's a guy he doesn't want around.
The world heavyweight champion is Booker T. Tell me a little bit about your respect level for our current world champion.
I like Booker. I mean, he's a good guy. He's a real deal.
And he has paid his dues, unlike Goldberg.
Yeah, Booker has paid his dues, and it's good to see guys like Booker make it. It's good. It's when he got, like when they put the strap on him in Daytona Beach. I when I watched the screen from the locker room, I thought to myself, even though I had a bad night, I looked at it and I said, you know, because I remember when I got the strap the first time, and no matter what you say, man, there's not a feeling like that. And I thought, you know, he's put in probably 10, 12 years, and tonight he's at the top, and it's a good feeling. I was happy for him.
And he earned it. He earned that spot.
Yeah.
Kevin, I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you this question. Internet full of rumors, the hotlines, the dirt sheets full of rumors.
Well, number one, let me just make a point known about the internet. All the internet does for people like me is invade my privacy. But go ahead.
Fair enough. Point well taken. However, the rumors are rampant that come August 13th at New Blood Rising on pay-per-view, there's a three-way dance.
There won't be no dance, but go ahead.
Three-way match, three-way brawl, three-way massacre. Kevin Nash, Goldberg, and Scott Steiner, the winner to get a world title shot at Fall Brawl on pay-per-view in September. To put it delicately, there apparently is some problem with who's going to come out on top in that match. And I guess the question is that going to be your final match if things really don't go your way?
Well, number one, things are going to go my way. I mean, no matter what this, you know, no matter how it's booked, laid out, argued, lobbied, I'm not going to lobby for a finish on this one. I'm just going to go out there. I bounced for 7 years before I got in this business, and I never got my ass kicked once. And I don't see it happening. I'm bigger than both those guys. I'm definitely meaner than both those guys.
What can we expect at New Blood Rising, then?
I'm going to go over, because I said so. And I'm not going to cry about it like the rest of them. I'm going to go over. It's my time to go over. It's my time period. You know, I got 17 months left here. I was one of the few guys that I gave my blood for this place. It's time for me to get mine, and then I'll go off in the sunset, but I'm getting mine.
That comes up August 13th at New Blood Rising in the three-way dance. You're going over?
I'm going over. Like Brett, I'm going to do the Bret Hart. I guarantee I'm going to win.